How's it going, everyone? This is Vertic. For this video, we're going to take a look at a quick and simple blend effect that you can do in Photoshop. If you want to, you can go ahead and look in the description. There'll be a link to these images so you can follow along. The first thing you want to do is we want to import this image, so you can left click and drag this into Photoshop. If you can't open it like this, you can go to File and Open. That works just the same. Next up, you want to get yourself the other image as well, so left click and drag it into Photoshop. And you pretty much want to scale this down to what you prefer. Now, if it makes it easier for you, you can turn down the opacity to about 50%, and then this makes it easier so you can see it. But then you want to press Ctrl T again so you can resize it and then scale it down a little bit more. If you can't press Ctrl T and this doesn't work for you, you can go to the Show Transform controls right here, and this lets you do it the same as well. But then you want to double left click on it, and then you want to untick it. But I like to use the shortcut, which is Ctrl T, and this allows me to edit it. So I'm gonna put it about here. I'm quite happy with it being here, so I'm gonna double left click, and then this will apply it. And then I'm gonna put the opacity up to 100% again. Now that I've done that, we're gonna create ourselves a mask. So if you press this icon down at the bottom right here, this will get yourself a mask. Once you've got yourself a mask, you wanna get yourself the brush tool, and you wanna make sure it's got a soft edge around it. So make sure the hardness is on 0. You want the size to be quite big as well. So you can either edit it here, or you can use the square bracket on your keyboard to make it larger or smaller. Once you've done that, you wanna get yourself a black color. Black will subtract and then white will add onto it. So the way that a mask works is we can use the black to take away the edges. And then if we want to re-add them, we'll use a white color. You want to make sure you are on the mask itself, so you can switch between these two. Just make sure this one is selected, otherwise it will paint on top of this one. So make sure it's selecting this one. And then once you're happy with it, you pretty much soften the edges nicely, so it looks like they are blended together. And there we go, that is not looking too bad. So now that we've done that, if you wanted to, you can give it an effect. So if you go where it says normal and then go to the one that says screen, this will pretty much give you this effect. Now, the only problem with this effect is that we can still see the ear. So what we want to do is we want to go on the background and then also create a mask on the background. You also want to get yourself a solid color. So if you go down here and go to solid color, get yourself a black and then put this one underneath and then go back to your background, click on the mask and then remove this from here like so. And now it's gone. You can always keep on editing this one if you're not happy with it. So if you want to take away a little bit more of the edges, for example, down here, you can always make it a little bit smaller and then just keep taking it away from here like so. Now what we're going to do is we're going to fix this one as well. So you can disable a mask if you hold shift and click on it. This will disable it. And I'm not quite happy with the bottom bit, so I'm going to take that away by getting a white color, making it a little bit smaller, and then getting rid of this here. Yeah, that's not looking too bad. I'm quite happy with this. It looks really cool so far. If you wanted to, you can also apply some color and you can apply some other things like a brightness and contrast. If you go on this one, go on the top layer, get yourself a brightness and contrast, and let's increase the brightness a little bit. Let's get yourself some contrast. And if you only wanted to apply to the image right here, you want to hold Alt, and then when this icon pops up, you pretty much left click, and that will only apply it to this layer right here. So as you can see, if we turn it off, it's only turned it off in here. And yeah, that is pretty much a quick blend effect that you can do yourself, and you can get really creative with this. So anyway, I will see you all next time. Bye.